And the obvious question anyone would say is, when should I use interferential on the infrex? When should I use TENS on the infrex? Perfectly legitimate question. We generally tell anyone starting off, I'll show you the unit here, almost always start off with interferential. You see it's plugged into the wall right now, and we always suggest when you start off with the infrex on interferential, use it as much as you can with it plugged into the wall. Now, if you can't do that, you're traveling, you're going somewhere, you're getting ready to start some type of activity that causes you pain, you can remove this and use the batteries. That's another way to use the unit. It is portable, and you can do it on interferential that way. But the other part of the infrex unit is the TENS part of the infrex unit. And one would say, well, when should I use TENS? Let me just give you a basic rule of thumb. We start you off with interferential. IFT is what it looks like on the unit. You use that almost all the time, first time, every time. What I'm saying is with interferential, it is immediate pain relief. When the machine is finished after a 30 to 45 minute treatment, you will go some time period before you're hurting again. That's called carryover. That's up on our website. Just type in carryover and explain more to you. But let's say you're getting ready to leave the house, you're going to work, and you've got a nagging pain, then you flip over to the TENS side of the unit. Here's the difference. You can wear TENS, use TENS 24/7. So anytime you're hurting or getting ready to do something which you know is going to be painful, put on your TENS unit. And that is already inside the Infrex Plus unit.